Hi friends, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.
Hi friends, my name is Fanindra Gupta. So in this video, let us discuss about regression analysis. So before entering into the calculation of the sum, firstly you have to know what are the formulas which are mainly useful for the calculation in this regression analysis. So now I'm going to give you a formulas. Please note it down such that you have to remember all of these formulas to calculate a sum. So if you see here, firstly, normal in the question, in the data, they will give you to calculate the regression as well as the significance also. So before entering into the calculation, you have to remember the formulas. So first, the first formula is B is equals to sigma dx dy by sigma dx square. So this formula is regression coefficient. Okay, regression coefficient is equals to sigma dx sigma dy by sigma dx square. And next, significance of the B. That's nothing but I have said you before only, right? They will ask you about regression as well as the significance. So if they ask regression coefficient, you have to apply this formula, and if they ask the significance, you have to apply the formula like this. If you see here, a significance of B is equals to, it is such a huge formula, try to remember this, root 1 by n minus 2 in whole sigma dy square minus whole sigma dx dy whole square by sigma dy square, close the bracket now. This both multiplication process, and by root sigma dx square. So this is the formula for the significance of the B. And if you see here now, after the calculation of this regression coefficient and the significance of the B, finally you have to join this. If you have to apply T is equals to B by significance of B. That's nothing but regression coefficient by significance of B. So the answer which you will get here in the regression coefficient and the answer which you will get in the significance of B, you have to divide it both. In such a way, you will get the final answer. So enough, I'm going to give you the data. So if you see here, normally, this is very important to remember. So before entering into the sum, firstly, you have to divide the, so you have to separate this formula. You have to know the value of sigma dx square, you have to know the value of sigma dy square, and you should also know the value of sigma dx dy. So if you separate these individuals, even these individuals have separate formulas. If you see here, sigma dx square is equals to sigma x square minus sigma x square whole by n, and next is sigma dy square is equals to sigma y square minus sigma y square by n, and in the same way, sigma dx dy is equals to sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y by n, right? And here n is nothing but number of variables. Okay, you have to count the variables. It will be denoted with x. You have to count each of the variable and how many variables are there. If you should write here, I'll go into explain enough. So in normal, I'm going to give you a data. So if you see here, in an ecological study, data recorded on fresh and dry weight for a sample of an experimental material, calculate the significance and regression. Okay, so here is a weight in grams and number of grains. So if you see here, 6, 10, 12, 4, 15, 12, 14, 8, 7, 5, and the number of grains are given below. Okay, so now let us calculate this this data by applying all of these formulas which I have said you now. So before calculating the sum, firstly you have to form a table. So here this table consists of variables, x, y, x square, y square, xy. So here x are nothing but the first row which I have set you here. So if you see here, this is the x row, this is the y row. Okay, x indicates weight in grams and y indicates number of grams. Okay, so here x, y, and you have to note down all the x values and all the y values. And next, here I have given you x square. X square is nothing but 6 square. 6 square is nothing but 36. 6 is 36, right? In the same way, 10 square, 100. 12 square, 144. 4 square, 4 4 is 16. 15, 15 is 225. 12, 12 is 144. In this way, you have to calculate this x square. Coming to the y square, in the same way, 3 3s are 9. 3 square is equals to 9. Again, 3 square is equals to 9. 4 square is equals to 16. 1 square is equals to 1. 5 square is equals to 25. In this way, you have to calculate this x square as well as the y square. And next, xy. X into y. 6 3s are 18, 10 3s are 30, 12 4s are 48. In this way, you have to calculate the total table. So now, at the last, you have to write the total. If you see here, sigma x, all of this row indicates sigma, x, right? So now, if you, sigma indicates adding of all of these variables. I mean, if you see here, 6 plus 10 plus 12 plus 4 plus 15 plus 12 plus 14 plus 8 plus 7 plus 5 is equals to 93. Okay, here sigma indicates sum, I mean addition of all of these variables. In the same way, sigma y is equals to 28. You have to add all of these values. And next, sigma x square, I mean sigma x square, you have to add all of these values. Coming to the sigma y square, you have to add all of these values. And here also sigma x y is nothing but you have to add all of these values. So remember these values, note it down. And now with the help of the formulas, let us calculate the sum. So I have said you before only, after the separation of these, you know, of these individuals, each that individual also consists of formulas. So now we have to apply first this individual, you know, individual formulas, such that you will get this total formula. Okay. So what is the first individual formula which you have to remember? Sigma dx square is equals to sigma x square minus sigma x whole square by n, right? So now in the table which we have formed, so normally what are the individuals which are present here? Sigma x square. So what is the sigma x square? We have to see here, sigma x square is equals to 999. So you have to note down here 999 minus again sigma x whole square. Sigma x whole square is nothing but sigma x 93 whole square. Sigma x whole square 93 whole square by 10. N is equals to number of variables. Okay, count here. How many variables are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So totally 10 variables are there here. So you have written here 10. So 999 minus 93 whole square, I mean sigma whole square by N is equals to 10 by 10. So now if you calculate this, you'll get the answer 134.1. Okay. So now first individual formula has been completed. Coming to the second individual formula, sigma dy square minus is equals to, sorry here, is equals to sigma dy square is equals to sigma y square minus sigma y whole square by n. Here sigma y square, what is the answer which we got here? 90. So 90 minus sigma y whole square, 28 whole square. If you see here 28, right? 28 square by 10, number of even number of variables, I mean. So if you calculate this, you will get the answer 11.6. And coming to the second one also we have completed. Coming to the last one, last individual formula, sigma dx dy is equals to sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y by n. So if you see here sigma xy, so what is the sigma xy formula which is answer which we got here? 293. So 293 minus sigma x, which what we got? 93. Sigma y 28 we got. And here n is equals to number of variables which we know here, 10. So here if you calculate this, you will get the answer 32.6. So we have completed all of these individual formulas. I mean, if you see here, before I have explained you, right, all of these individual formula we have completed. So now as we got this answer, you can substitute those answers within this formula, I mean significance of the B. Right, so what is the data which was given here? Calculate the significance and regression. So now let us calculate the significance, because we already got these answers, so it will be easy for this for this calculation. So remember this formula, and now let us apply this answers in this formula. So coming to this calculation significance of B, so what, this is the formula, right? So up to here this will be the formula. And now if you substitute root 1 by n minus 2. Now how many variables are there? 10 minus 2. So what is the sigma dy square formula which we got? I mean in the individual type before I said you, right? 11.6 we got. And here sigma dx dy whole square, I mean 32.6. We just got sigma dx dy, that's it. Whole square you have to apply here. So 32.6 is the answer. And if you apply this whole square here, then 1062.76 will be the answer. And next, sigma dy square is 134.1. If you see here, all of these which we got here, right? All of the values which we got here. That's only the answer which we are calculating here. I mean, substituting here. Okay. Sigma dx square root 134.1. I mean, root sigma dx square root 134.1. And in this way, if you calculate all of these, you will get the final answer. So what is the answer which you will get? 0.06. Okay. 0.06 is the answer. And next, up to here, now what is the data which was given here? We got the significance. And here he also asked that calculate the significance and regression. Significance we have calculated. So what is the significance answer which we got here? 0.06. So now he also asked calculate the regression. So now let us see the regression. So what is the regression coefficient, formula which I have said you before, b is equals to sigma dx dy by sigma dx square. So if you see here, this is the regression coefficient formula, right? And what is the sigma dx dy for answer which we got 32.6, and sigma dx square is equals to 134.1, and if you divide this, what is the answer which you will get? 0.24. So now if you see here, this formula we calculated, and even this formula you have to calculate it. Now you have to substitute these both values. So normally we will write here, so what is the value which we got here in this regression coefficient? 0.24. So now what is the value which we got here in this significance? 0.06, right? 0.06. So these are the both values which we got in the significance of b as well as the regression coefficient. So now you have to substitute these both values in this. So if you see here, this t is equals to b by significance of b. Here b indicates regression coefficient by significance of b. That's nothing but 0.24 divided by 0.06. okay, 0.24 divided by 0.06. So what is the answer? T is equals to 4. And in the same way, you have to write the result. Okay. So this is about the regression analysis. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. Thank you.